Your two favorite things, soup and jerky, combined at last. Will it be awesome? Will it be unedible?
I think I may have ruined my first batch of soup.
This does not look good.
Oh. Son of a
damn. Cloudy in the morning, gonna be raining in the afternoon. And if you don't like this rainy weather, you better pack your bags and move.
I went to gather chestnuts the other day and there were no chestnuts. So I'm going to officially say that the season is over. And I'm kind of curious how many I gathered. So that's about 2 pounds right there. I'm going to go ahead and say there's 20 or 30 pounds of chestnuts in here. Unfortunately, when I was looking at them, I could see that some of them are sprouting mold, which has been the bane of my existence.
I think it was, you know, I was collecting them in the rain a couple days, and I brought them back, and I thought they were dry.
So I'm going to make this little screen in there, and I'm going to elevate it just a little bit so they'll sit up off the bottom of the oven, and hopefully it'll stop them getting scorched.
There's our mush. Actually, it doesn't look bad. Let's try one of these chestnuts.
It's still pretty chewy. I probably should have cooked it longer, but totally edible and really tasty, really sweet.
Yeah, hopefully by cutting my oatmeal with these chestnuts, I can make this last maybe even all winter.
I'm actually gonna lose it here pretty soon. The worst part is I usually love rainy days. I love to like make a big fire, maybe read a book, watch some good zombie movies, bake something, or make like a big feast, hang out with people, play some board games. And no, it's just me and Howard.
Howard,
entertain me. Hey, ooh. Ooh, that is kind of entertaining. I estimate this to be between a quarter and a fifth of my entire walnut stash. The greenhouse is nice on rainy days because I can still get some work done. It's pretty cool actually because I just looked over here and look at all these Toro de Rosso peppers. They're all setting up. All my fava beans and peas are looking pretty miserable over here. They're not getting enough light, I guess. So right now I'm tying these strings onto the roof and I'm gonna try and train them up these strings.
My dad is leaving for Mexico tomorrow, so I thought I'd make him his Christmas present, which is a little keychain for his boat. He's gonna go hang out in the Sea of Cortez on his sailboat. That'll help him not lose the keys to his boat when he's having too many margaritas.
I have here something very exciting to show you. What do you think's in the bag? What's in the bag, man? I'm very excited about this thing here. Let's see if I can get this out without hurting myself. Whoa there, buddy. Whoa.
I found this giant crab in a tide pool this afternoon. I'm like beside myself with how cool this is. Especially after I had Mark's crab and it was here, and because of some stupid zap technicality, I had to give it to my neighbors.
Crab is on the menu tonight. Oh my god, it smells so good. It is almost winter solstice. I believe today is the 19th. It hasn't been sunny in about 10 days. So I haven't had a shower in 10 days. We're gonna see if the solar heater is working on some of the shortest days of the year here.
All right, first, what is the temperature of the water coming out of the hose? 59 degrees.
Feels like it's gotten about lukewarm to me. Not quite like it was this summer when it was scalding hot and I had to add cold water.
I think it's fairly obvious now that I should have made the solar shower during the winter. It is definitely not warm though. So I'm doing it like a military style, get wet, soap up, and then wash off type shower. It's supposed to rain tomorrow, too, so it's just gotta happen.
Let's check the temperature of the shower water. Oh, around about 69 degrees.
I picked this strange vine when I was in Chicago last year with Allison. They were just growing everywhere back there. But the vine here kind of looks like my sweet potato vine. And what really got me was they have really similar flowers.
So I thought for kicks I'd just dig around and see if there was any root similarity. Maybe this is some strange sweet potato that they've domesticated in Chicago. I can't believe that that vine is actually like made like some sort of food. Look at that. Holy cow. It's a sweet potato. I'm like totally dumbfounded by this.
There you go. I grew a sweet potato completely on accident from a cutting that I smuggled back. I'm totally gonna eat this thing for dinner. All right, here are our mystery tubers. Anyway, I'm gonna try and eat them. They look like some really starchy and wonderful and high in calories. Doesn't smell like anything. Tastes very woody and kind of bland. Chop those up and they go in our broth that I made last night with my pumpkin guts and some kale. And then I also have the last of my little mussels from my last ocean mission. Half an avocado, a couple of leftover tomatoes, little squashies, there's peppers, and some leek tops and kale. That's it. That's dinner.
Here's our mystery potato soup. Now, how do these things taste? I mean, gosh, that almost looks like a potato.
Wow, that's delicious. It's just like a potato, but it's a little sweeter and has a really smooth texture. So take note, if you live in the Midwest and the world melts down and the zombies are after you, look in the planter boxes. If it's ornamental, it might be edible.
I was about to drink this pomegranate juice, and I'd kind of been thinking about a post-apocalyptic tattoo and what you would use for ink. And I had noticed that it really stained my chopping board badly. And after I saw that, I really couldn't get it out of my mind that maybe it would make some good ink.
Here's the pomegranate juice. As you can see, it's like pretty inky already. Hopefully if I boil this down, it's just gonna concentrate that pigment and also gonna really help sanitize the whole thing too.
The pomegranate juice actually dyed the inside of this jar. So there might be a hope for us actually making some sort of tattoo ink out of this stuff.
So I decided that just since I was using pomegranate juice, I would just tattoo a pomegranate on my hand here. I don't have any color tattoos, so this is kind of weird for me.
Alright, here's my tattoo supplies. There's my red ink, I could just use that, I guess. Of course, all this stuff requires power, so it doesn't do me much good.
Here's the needle I've selected. This is a 5-round needle.
Oh man, that is inky.
You better save your dimes in their course. Better save them for a rainy day.
There you go. A pomegranate tattoo with pomegranate ink. Man, that was freaking gnarly. The ink just didn't really want to go in. It was too thick at first, so I had to water it down. But you can see my hand is super swollen right now and pretty much can't get any more ink in there. I went over it about 3 times. We'll see what it looks like when it dries. And I just realized that if I want to do a touch-up, I'm going to have to can my pomegranate juice.
So check this out. That is an average-sized acorn. This is a large acorn. And I found this acorn today. It's insane. It's by far twice as big as any other acorn I've found. I mean, look at that.
This acorn is so impressive that I don't think it deserves to be eaten. It's like the bulls in the bullfights. When they fight hard enough, they actually let them go to stud. So this acorn is going to be selected to produce a new superior race of acorns that will provide us with extra nourishment and massive acorn stores in about 100 years.
Edible tubers.